Let's look at an example of a problem which asks to calculate the geometric average annual return. So let's say we are given the following returns. Let me just make something up. Let's say we have a 10% return, then we have a negative 15% return, and the third one is 20%. Okay, so this is what we are given. And now how are we going to calculate their geometric average? Let me pick the blue color. So there are two ways how you can do it. One, you can do it by hand using the following formula. You open parentheses where you have the product of three things which are linked to these three returns that are given for each year. So 1 plus the first return, let's do it in decimals, 0.1, multiplied by 1 plus the second return. However, because it's negative, we use the minus sign, so minus 0.15. And then we multiply it by the third term, which is 1 plus the third return. In decimals, that's plus 0.2. And then the whole thing, the whole product of these three terms is taken to the power 1/3, where 3 is always the number of the returns that are given to you. And then you subtract 1. So if you do the math this way, you will get 3.91%. 3.91%. This is the answer. But there is a second way of doing it using the financial calculator. So let's do the following. We have year 0, year 1, year 2, and year 3. Right? So let's make something up for year 0. You just make it up. Make up some dollar amount. And the meaning of it will be, because we're talking about returns on stock investment, for example, the meaning of year 0 dollar amount would be how much you paid to buy, let's say, one share of stock. So let's make it $100, right? And I'm gonna, add this note here, make it up. Right? So you completely make it up. It's completely up to you if it's $100 or $1 or $5 or anything else. Okay, so if it's $100 that you're paying today to buy one share of stock, then after 1 year, what will be the price per share if the return is 10%? Well, it's going to be a 10% higher price. So we can do it in the financial calculator by using $100 from year 0 as our present value, and we would want to make it negative. Then n equals 1, because we are doing it after just 1 year, and IY, the interest rate, is what's given for the first year, 10%. And we are computing the future value. So let me bring up the financial calculator. Let's turn it on. 100 negative is our present value. 1 is our n, 10 is our IY, and we are compute future value, 110, just like we expected. Okay, so 110. Then the second year calculations of stock price in dollars are done the same way. So now the price is 110, that's the PV. Right? And we make it negative again, 110. Again, we want to see what the price will be 1 year later. So the N is still 1. It's not 2, but it's still 1. We are doing everything in 1 year increments. IY, the return on the stock investment, right? During the second year, that's a negative 15% return. So that's my IY. And I'm computing the future value. Okay. Financial calculator again. We can actually leave the answer on the display, change the sign of it to negative, and then save it as PV. So now we are beginning the year 2 calculation. N equals 1, so I press 1, N. 15 negative, right? I'm doing 15, then plus minus, then iy, and I'm computing future value. And as expected, because of the negative return, the price should be less than $110. It's now $93.50. Okay. $93.50 is the new price. And then we repeat the same thing one last time for year three. So PV is negative 93.5 and is again 1 because we are looking at the change in stock price over one extra year. IY is the third return that's given, which is 20%. Okay, so I put 20 and I'm again computing the future value. Let's see what that's going to be. Okay, so this becomes my present value and I need to make it negative first. Negative PV. 1N 20 IY compute future value. 112.20, right? $112.20. So $112.20. And the last step is the following. So here's the last step. The last step is we are taking this price from year zero, our starting point, and the price that we calculated for end of year three. And now we are doing the following. Present value is $100 from year zero. Then future value is the last price that we found, 112.20. They are 3 years apart, and we want to compute the implied interest rate or growth that allows a $100 price per share to sort of gradually grow over the 3 years to $112.20. Compute IY. Okay, let's try that. So this is my future value. I'm hitting FV again to save it. Then 100, and I'm making this one negative, was my original present value. 3N, they are 3 years apart, and I'm computing IY. 3.91, just like in the calculation I did first using this long formula. So 3.91%. 3.91%. Again, exactly the same answer. So it's up to you if you are comfortable with this complicated formula with double parentheses and the power, which is a fraction, and so on. If you know the order of operations and are sure you can do it right, then you can go ahead and do it all in one step. Or you can do it and then just double check your math using the financial calculator steps. Now, let me give you one more explanation for the geometric average return. So we're basically saying that, so this is time, right? So we have year 0, 1, 2, and 3. And so let's say we are talking about buying shares of stock from some company. So instead of saying that, so we start somewhere here, I just randomly pick this point, and then the price grows to by 10%, right? Over the first year. So this is plus 10%. Then what we are given is a 15% drop. So something like this, right? So it's minus 15%. And then we have a 20% jump. So something like this, right? So plus 20%. So what we are doing now is with the 3.91% geometric average, we are kind of allowing the price to slowly grow from this starting point, whatever that is, and we decided it, that it's going to be $100, for example, to something at the end of 3 years, which in our example is $112.20, right? So we have plus 3.91% per year. And I'm going to add something clarifying, compounded annually, right? And so the way we interpret the geometric average is, we would say something like this. If you invest your money for 3 years, you're not saying 1 year, right? For 3 years, the entire investment period that we are given, then the money will be growing on average by 3.91% per year, comma, compounded annually. With the arithmetic average, you instead say that the return you earn on average every year is so-and-so percent when the money is invested for just 1 year. So with the geometric average, it's not a 1 year investment. It's a multi-year investment. In our problem, it's a 3 year investment.